Most people don't understand that malaria still remains a really serious problem.
It has enormous effects on lives in Africa, and each person understands it well because of what it does to families.
I took my child to the hospital, and within 2 hours, my child was gone.
There has never been a vaccine for control of malaria that has ever been approved. The RTSS malaria vaccine candidate has been in the works now for 30 years. Malaria is spread when you are bitten by a female Anopheles mosquito. It transmits parasites onto your bloodstream, which then triggers certain symptoms.
When my son was dying with malaria, there was fever, convulsion, and vomiting.
You want a doggy?
Huh? Ah. Ah, sawa.
In Kombewa, malaria is with us the whole year round. A vaccine would be an added tool to complement the existing interventions.
Because it strengthens your immunity in the body.
In the effort to come up with a malaria vaccine, we are aiming at children specifically because the under fives are regarded as vulnerable because they've not developed immunity.
The first 3 malaria vaccine trial had more than 15,000 children enrolled. Slightly more than 1,600 children were from Kombewa.
I personally used the experience from my child's death to educate the community.
The scope of this project is a big deal. Kombewa is just one of the sites that is participating in the malaria fight.
It demonstrates the capacity of African scientists to conduct high quality and groundbreaking research, to collaborate and to work together to resolve big problems that affect the continent. RTSS would be the first vaccine not only against malaria, but against a human parasite. It's historical.
Just because we have a potential vaccine does not mean that we don't work hard. We still need to continue with the research.
With the malaria vaccine, we could cut down deaths drastically.
Since the death of my son, I've had another son, which I hope is going to gain from this vaccine. My son represents the future.